Like what? Capitan L. I am showing Senor Cholby a page from the internet site www.eldescarorocks.com. JC. R. Capitan L. You know of this page? JC. I do. Capitan L. Would you care to explain? JC. You would need to talk to my client about that. Capitan L. And what will she say? JC. That I helped her with the wording. Capitan L. And? JC. It's... Capitan L. Sighs. Chapter 27. Back to bed. The walk down the hill is slow and painful. My leg hurts, but the bigger pain is the one in my head, the bursting headache from trying to figure out what to do next. The expatriates and Pat are both serious about the threats. I've no reason left to think otherwise. I can't win here. If the expatriates go down for the scam, so do I. If I don't find the money, Pat will hand over the tape and the expatriates will still implicate me in the scam. If, by some miracle, I find the money and give it to the expatriates, Pat will hand over the tape. If I find the money and give it to Pat, I go down with the expatriates. I'm screwed every way up. I keep my eyes open for either Zia or George's car, while contemplating the only option open to me. Run. Get on a plane and head home. Except that isn't an option that will play out well. The police can easily stretch across Europe and bring me back here, and I haven't enough cash to vanish. I could hide somewhere and try to arrange to sell the pub and apartment, find a way to sneak the money home. How? No idea.